Beloved in Christ, be it this Christmastide our care and delight, to hear again the message of the angels, and with heart and mind, to go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass and to be enlightened in a manger. Therefore, let us read and mark in Holy Scripture the tale of the loving purposes of God, from the first days of our disobedience unto the glorious redemption brought us by this Holy Child. But first, let us pray for the needs of the whole world, for peace on earth and goodwill among all his people, for unity and brotherhood within the church he came to build, and especially in this chapel of the Holy Undivided Trinity of Glenalmond College, in the Diocese of St. Andrews. And because of all things, this of all things would rejoice his heart, let us remember in his name the poor and helpless, the cold, the hungry and the oppressed, the sick and them that mourn, the lonely and the unloved, the aged and the little children, all those who know not the Lord Jesus, or who love him not, or who by sin have grieved his heart of love. Lastly, let us remember before God all those who rejoice with us, but upon another shore and in a greater light, that multitude which no man can number, whose hope was in the Word made flesh, and with whom, in the Lord Jesus, we are forever one. These prayers and praises let us humbly offer up to the throne of heaven, in the words which Christ himself hath taught us. We say together, Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Adam and his wife hid themselves in the presence of the Lord God said, "Who told thee that thou wast naked? Hast thou eaten of the tree whereof I commanded thee that thou shouldest not eat?" And the man said, "The woman who thou gavest to be with me, she gave me of the tree, and I did eat." And the Lord God said unto the woman, "What is this that thou hast done?" And the woman said, "The serpent beguiled me, and I did eat." And the Lord God said unto the serpent, "Because thou hast done this, thou art cursed above all cattle, and above every beast of the field. Upon thy belly shalt thou grow, and thus shalt thou eat all the days of thy life. And I will put enmity between thee and the woman, and between thy seed and her seed. It shall bruise thy head, and thou shalt bruise his heel." Here ends the lesson.
Thank you. thou hast not listened, and hast not withheld thy son, thine only son, then in blessing I will bless thee, and in multiplying I will multiply thy seed as the stars of the heaven, and as the sand upon the sea, and thy seed shall possess the gate of his enemies, and in thy seed shall the nations of the earth be blessed, because thou hast obeyed my voice. Here ends the blessing.
Thank you.
Christ's birth and kingdom are foretold by Isaiah. The people that walk in darkness have seen a great light. They that dwell in the land of the shadow of death. Upon the top the light shines. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace there shall be no end, upon the throne of God and upon his kingdom, to order it and to establish it with judgment and with justice, from henceforth even forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will be faultless. He ends the lesson.
Prophet Micah foretells the glory of Bethlehem. The bell
Bethlehem Ephrata, thou wilt be little among the thousands of Judah. Yet out of thee shall he come forth unto me, that is true ruler of Israel. His goings forth will be from of old, from everlasting. Therefore will he give them up, until the time of two which travaileth be brought forth. Then the remnant of his brethren shall return to the children of Israel. And he shall stand and feed in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God, and they shall abide. For now shall he be great unto the ends of the earth. The end of the lesson.
Blessed art thou among women,
And when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and cast in her mind what manner of salutation there should be. And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favour with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb, and bring forth a son, and shalt call his name Jesus. He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest, and the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David. And he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there shall be no end. Then said Mary unto the angel, How shall this be, seeing I know not a man? And the angel answered, and said unto her, The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore also that holy thing which shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God. And behold, thy cousin Elizabeth, she has also conceived a son in her old age, and this is the sixth month with her, who was called barren. For with God nothing shall be impossible. And Mary said, Behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be it unto me according to thy word. And the angel departed from her. Here is the word.
Thank you. garden, and then he saw a tree. And the angel said unto them, fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David, a Saviour, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was the angel, a multitude of the heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest and on earth peace, goodwill towards men. And it came to pass that the angels were gone away from them and into heaven. The shepherds said to one another, let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see the thing which hath come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger. Here ends the lesson.
King of the Jews, for we have seen his star in the east and are come to worship him, When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he demanded of them where Christ should be born. And they said unto him, In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophet, And thou, Bethlehem, the land of Judah, art not the least among the princes of Judah, for out of thee shall come a governor that shall rule my people of Israel. Then Herod, when he had called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, Go and search diligently for the young child, and when you have found him, bring me word again, that I may come and worship him also. When they entered the king, they departed, and lo, the star which they saw in the east went before them, till it came and stood where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh. Here ends the lesson.
Father, full of grace and truth. Here ends the lesson.
Families in this holy season. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus Christ, cradled in a manger, we pray for refugees and all who are displaced from their homes this Christmas by war, poverty, addiction, or broken relationships. Lord, in your mercy. Lord Jesus Christ, sharing the stable with the animals, we pray for all of God's creation and that we might be good and faithful stewards. Lord, in your mercy. Lord Jesus Christ, worshipped by shepherds and kings, we pray for all who care for your flock in this place. We pray for King Charles, for this land of Scotland, and for all nations represented in our college. Lord, in your mercy. Lord Jesus Christ, our Emmanuel, we pray for all known to us, who in particular need this night of the presence of the Prince of Peace. For the bereaved, the anxious, and the sick, remembering especially Mrs. Butler at this time. Lord, in your mercy. Lord Jesus Christ, in you heaven came down to earth, and earth was raised to heaven. Hold in your hand all those we love who have passed through death in the hope of your coming kingdom. Lord, in your mercy.
Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you.
appearance of the wise men, the obedience of Mary and Joseph, and the peace of the Christ child be yours this Christmas, and the blessing of the triune God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost be with you and those you love this Christmas tide and evermore. Amen.